tell us who you are and where your farm is.
Okay. I'm Eric Ooms, and I'm the Vice President of New York Farm Bureau, and we have a farm in Kinderhook, New York.
And is it a family farm?
Yes. My father, two brothers, and I are in partnership, and our younger generation is coming along.
So tell us about the younger generation, because we just heard in the news conference that there aren't many younger people. It's either 25 or 75, mostly 75 years old.
Well, I'm kind of at a tough spot because I've been the younger generation, but now I have my own kids. So my kids love the farm, they're babies, but my teenage nieces and nephews are doing all the ag things and 4-H and FFA and so forth, and just getting involved, and we're hopeful. That after they get done with high school or college, whatever, they'll come back to the farm.
And you said that before you came here to this news conference, you milked a cow.
Absolutely.
And what is your day like normally?
I get up at 3:30, and I milk till about 6 when my brother takes over for me, and he finishes milking till about 8. And then I do some other things. I feed the cows, and then I take a nap during the day, like about an hour or so, except for today because I'm here. And then in the afternoon, I do what needs to be done around the barn, whether it be clean the stalls or during the summer, do a lot of mowing hay or chopping corn. Or just the great thing about being on the farm is that there's no 2 days that are the same. On weekends, I'll be milking in the afternoon. A regular day, I don't milk in the afternoon. It varies. That's why I love being home on the farm, is because it allows me to do something different every day.
So talk about the struggles you have for owning a farm.
The big challenge is just trying to keep up with piles of regulations. One thing that really helps with our family is I have two brothers involved on the farm, so we kind of parcel out who takes care of what and who has responsibility for what. That's kind of helpful. I see, like, I have another brother who milks cows by himself. He's doing it all himself, milking 70 cows. It just blows your mind. I mean, it's bad enough for us, but when it's just one person doing it, it makes it even harder. So that's one challenge. And then the other challenge is just something you deal with is the weather. I mean, last year turned out to be an okay year for us. But if our fruit growing neighbors that had apples had an awful year, because it was so warm in March, all the trees flowered and then it frosted and they had little to no apples. I talked to an apple farmer this morning who had a 60% crop and is happy. He said it was a great year because he had 60%, because I talked to someone last night who had a 2% crop. So, and the other side of that is, from their perspective, is you've got a farm stand, you're an apple farmer, you've got a farm stand, you've got like a 5% or a 2% crop. You can't advertise that, because then your neighbors say, oh, there's no point in going there. Well, they'll buy the apples from someone else. I know a lot of apples from the Champlain Valley came into the Hudson Valley this year, because the Champlain Valley had a bumper crop, and the Hudson Valley was spotty. Some places were huge, and some places not so much. And because they have to keep their market for their consumers. Once a consumer changes a habit, they don't come back. So that's a challenge that dairy farmers take for granted that we don't deal with, because dairy farmers, as Senator Young was talking about, have a fixed price. So we're kind of captive. But the positive of it is we have a market. So it's a trade-off.
So what do you do with the milk that you produce through your dairy farm?
Okay, our milk, we belong to Agrimark Cooperative, which owns Cabot and Macadam Cheese. But also, a couple days a week, our milk goes into Manhattan to a little artisanal cheese maker called Beecher's Cheese. And we just got the first cheese out of there. There's two farms in Kinderhook area that take milk down to New York City about 4 days a week to make cheese for Beecher's Cheese. So that's pretty exciting. But Cabot is also another great story that's actually grown and prospered and added value to our bottom line.
Yeah, one last question. What do you think about this legislation that the Senate Republicans have just put out today?
I think it's a great package, and as much of it as we can possibly get passed would be great. From my perspective, as a family that just finished a generational transfer, the estate tax is a big deal. But it's all a big deal. The assessment going up at 10% a year just is not sustainable. That's very important. There's so many other factors, but I guess from my perspective, as just having finished in December 30th, transferring from my father to us, that's critical, because it was a 25 to 30 year process to transfer from my father to us. So I got to start thinking about transferring to my kids, but if this passes, it won't be a 25 year process. It'll be hopefully a 5 year process. You still have to plan. this bill will not take all the risk out, but we can't expect government to do that. But it will definitely make things a lot easier.